Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to Muhammad Sheikh's channel. Please click the bell icon so that you may receive timely notifications of our upcoming videos.
Suppose someone here in the audience really accepts it through the heart, the spirit will enter, or you will receive that spirit. So what will happen? Their family members and their people whom he's brought up, he has a particular concept, he himself, before coming to this place. He has got some concept and ideology and philosophy. What he thinks in his mind is right. So he will change that concept, what he had before. The concept derived here by the ayahs will change if Allah guides, to whom Allah guides, if he changes. So his people in circle will say, what happened to you? Where do you go? So you must have not gone there, because now you are a changed person. You don't want to believe what you had been believing in the past. That is known as the direction of belief change, Qibla in Arabic. In Arabic, Qibla means the direction of belief. Whenever the direction of belief is changed, so people come to know what happened. There's something different. So direction of belief change, then Allah guides. So now I read Al-Baqarah 2 and Ayah 142, it is explaining that thing. سَيَقُولُ سُفَاهُ مِنَ النَّاسِ مَا وَلَّهُمْ عَنْ قِبْلَةُمَ الَّتِي كَانُوا عَلَيْهَا قُلْ لِلَّهِ الْمَشْرِقُ وَالْمَغْرِبِ يَعْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ إِلَىٰ صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. The fools among the peoples will say, what has reverted them from their Qibla? They were over it. Qibla means front, or they were over it. Say, for Allah is east and the west, he guides whom he wills to the straight path. Now if that person in the audience goes there in their circles and he says, I am different now. I think all I've been learning all my life is wrong, and I'm changing myself, I'm different. So those people will say, what has turned you from your Qibla? Who has turned you? What has turned you from the direction what you were on it? So Allah says, they are the fools who are saying this. So Allah says, the fools among the people will say, what has diverted you from the Qibla that you were on it? Because you did not knew the understanding and the essence of the book of Allah. So you changed when you heard the essence and the spirit came to you. Once you change, so Allah is telling them, they are the fools. The fools among the people will say, what has diverted you from the Qibla that you were on it? Whatever the ideology you had before, you have changed. So they are saying, they say, what changed you? So Allah answers, not Muhammad Sheikh, قُلِ اللَّهُ الْمَشْرِقُ وَالْمَغْرِبُ. Say, for Allah belongs the east and the west. Yahdi, he guides whom he wills to a straight path. So when Allah guides people to the straight path, they can never ever remain on their Qibla, their direction of belief. They can never ever remain on their direction of belief, their own ego's belief, their own fantasies, their own fancies. They can never. They will change. And not because of me, it is Allah. He says, قُلِ اللَّهِ الْمَشْرِقُ وَالْمَغْرِبُ. It is for Allah belongs the east and the west. يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ إِلَىٰ صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. He guides to the straight path. And first ayat I read, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. Guide us onto the straight path. So Allah says, يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ إِلَىٰ صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. He is guiding you to the straight path. So whenever you revert to the Qibla, there are no two straight paths. There is one straight path. And that change cannot come from by yourself until Allah guides. Until Allah guides, you can never change your direction. You will remain as it is. No matter how thousand lectures you listen or read the Quran 100 times. It has to come from God. It is Allah who changed the Qibla direction belief all the time. Now this Qibla of ours is Surah Al-Imran 3:96 and 97. Inna wa la baytin wudhiya linnasi lalladhi bi bakkata mubarakam wa hudal lil alamin. The first house appointed for the people that is at Bekka, is that at Bekka of blessing and guidance for all worlds. Now fifth, sixth is included. Once was the direction of belief, book, Quran, prophets, messenger, human being, and now the house. Look, it says, Inna wa labayd wudhiya linnasi lalladhi bibakkata mubarak wa hudalli lalameen, a guidance for all worlds. This is also guidance. The first house. The first house, the Kaaba, the sacred mosque, the Masjid al-Haram, is also a place of guidance. This ayah, Inna wa labaytim wudhiya linnasi lalladhi bibakkata mubarakam wa hudalli lalameen. It is a place of blessing and a guidance for all worlds, all times. So if you have got that concept, no matter you are going praying salah, doing qiyam, ruku, sujood, and doing tawaf, but you have got this is our second house, this is our second house. First house was Jerusalem house, first house was Jerusalem, because there were 360 gods in there, and people were going in naked tawaf and all nonsense. So this is a place of blessing and a guidance for all worlds. You have to believe in this, believe me. This is a test. Either you believe the history or you believe the ayats. So people say, you don't believe history. I say, you don't believe ayats. I am accountable to Allah. I am accountable to Allah to the Day of Judgment by the ayats, not by history. If the whole mankind say that there were 360 gods, I will never believe it, idols. Me personally, I don't want to talk about you. Because I believe this is a blessing and a guidance for all worlds. And what guidance I bring? The prayer, the salah, the prayer. How do you pray? They say there is no mention in the Quran how to pray. The next ayah says, Fihi ayatum bayinat maqamu Ibrahim. Waman dakhalahu kana amina walillahi ala nasi hajjul bayt man istata'a ilayhi sabila waman kafara fa inna Allah ghaniyun ala alameen. In it are clear ayahs, the standing position of Ibrahim. Who enters it attains security. And for Allah is pilgrimage of the house, of the people, those who can afford the journey to it. And if anyone rejects, so surely Allah is not needful from his words. I'm reading this ayat. It says, in it, in the house are clear ayahs, clear ayahs. Ayahs clear. The ayahs that are clear to you is the position, standing position of Ibrahim. Whoever enters in it comes in security. And for Allah is pilgrimage, Hajj. Of the house of the people, those who can afford the journey. And if anyone rejects, surely Allah is not needful from his words. Do you think that I today, reading this ayah, it was not read 1400 years back? If it was read 1400 years back, so do you think people would have said there are tawaf is going naked and all this rubbish is going? You are saying that it's a place of blessing, there is no blessing. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in history is reciting these ayahs. Don't think Mama Sheikh came and recited. These are decided at that time. So when it was decided at that time, people have said, there are idols in the house. Another ayat says, وَاتَّخِذُوا مِن مَقَامِ إِبْرَاهِيمُ صَلَّىٰ and take from the standing position of Ibrahim your salah, the prayer. It's in the eyes. So Imam is there, the tawaf is there, the qiyam, ruku, sujood is there, the hajj was going before Ibrahim al-Islam. So, in the house of Allah, the standing position of Maqam Ibrahim is there, where Imam stands to pray. So everything is there before. We have come here to follow all what is already being done. We don't have to invent anything. When the Quran says it is a barakat, it's a blessing and a guidance, I believe.